With me here in the studio this morning from Minergy, I'm joined by Morné du Plessis. Morné, good morning.
Morning to you.
Look, it's been about a month, I think, or thereabouts, since we last caught up on Skype. So give us a quick update. What's happening on site at the moment?
So from an operational perspective, we're very busy. After fine-tuning and looking at all the leaks and electrical connections that we wanted to sort out and so forth, the operation's going well. We've been successfully putting product consistently through the plant, and we are producing sellable product to the qualities that we're expecting, creating our stockpiles and so forth. So it's been quite exciting for us to get through the development phase and now into an operational phase.
And how much are you producing at the moment?
Well, at the moment, our objective is from a mining perspective. We'll mine about 100,000 tons a month. That gives you saleable product of about 70,000 a month. So we're gearing towards that. In August, we did smaller volumes because we were still fine-tuning. So, September is the month that we've targeted for, 70,000, albeit that, it may be rolling over into October and so forth as you fine-tune as you go along.
And you've made some shipments of product to, is it South Africa and Namibia?
Correct. So, typically, we would have any customer, before they want to engage on a longer term with you, they want to test the product. So we've had a significant interest. The customers have come out to the site, some of them have done site visits, others have placed orders for a trial load, 500 tons here, 1,000 tons here, even in excess of that, gone back to their facilities, tested it in their facilities, very happy with the qualities, and from there we now are going to have the bigger orders coming through. So smaller initially for the trials, but now we're seeing the orders coming through.
And so where are you at as far as offtakes?
We're quite pleased to announce that we are in the final stages of closing an offtake agreement. It will probably be for about 10% of our annual nameplate saleable coal. And again, as we've always said, it is for the smaller fraction, which is the one that you want to contractualize first. And so we're very pleased with that, happy with the terms and conditions and so forth. Looking forward to start signing that off and then delivering on it.
I know there's probably little that you can tell me at this stage, but whereabouts are they? Are you able to tell us that?
What I can say to you, it's an industrial customer from South Africa.
Right.
And it's typically, the market that takes a smaller fraction is normally your cement and lime. So, you can take it from there.
What about the Botswana market?
The Botswana market is smaller than the South African market, but we've been inundated on calls from them as well. Again, from a location and geographical advantage, we're closer to that specific market than, let's say, some of the other players. And they've tested our product as well, specifically with the guys around the border as well, which is very close to our mine.
So as far as expenditure on site and CapEx, so most of those big ticket items, they've been taken care of now, have they?
Correct. So your big ticket items would normally be your box cut, so that's taken care of. And then the plant is financed on a boot mechanism, which is build, own, operate and transfer, and it's carried by the contractor. So that is in place. We are making modifications to the plant as we go along. But from a CapEx perspective, we've spent basically the bulk of it. There is some smaller items, like an access road here and there that we'll do, but we're doing that out of current cash flows.
And what about activities on the marketing side? Have you been getting the message out there?
We have. It's been actually a process that's been going on for a while in the background. So between our marketing manager, Lynette, and Andre, who's still advising us on a strategic basis, they've been inundated with calls from the different markets, and the guys have been working hard on it. So we're following through on all of those at the moment. So there is appetite in the market, and specifically, the customers are very interested in the stability of supply we can guarantee. Again, the problem in the Southern African market is that you have situations where if the export price it takes a bit of a dive like it has, there's a bit of flooding into the domestic market, but the big players normally switch on and off what they put into the domestic market. So the customer base is not happy with that. They want a stable supply. They can set their facilities to optimum efficiencies and get the best out of it. So that's what we're putting on the table, and they're enjoying. They want to see that.
So you've been encouraged by the demand.
Yeah. So the domestic demand in South Africa has shown a trend for over the last 5 years of probably increasing of in excess of 50%. Now, the domestic market is it's got different segments, but what we're interested in, we can see a consistent growth there. So there is a consistent request for this supply of this product.
How's the cash at Minergy? Have you got enough to get you through the foreseeable future?
Yeah, so cash is it's an ongoing project. You know, people talk about turnover being vanity, cash is reality. So for us as a startup mine, we specifically look at mechanisms how we can optimize our cash. So one of the mechanisms would be to engage with customers and say to them, listen, in terms of taking terms, can we get upfront payments and so forth? The news and the feedback from the market has been very positive on that specifically. So, you know, that's how we're going to manage our cash, with aggressive upfront collection of our cash on that side. So it's tough, but we're getting through this.
Is a dual listing here in London, is that still on the cards for you?
It is. We are this week actually going through what's called an early look, which will give us an indication if there's appetite or not. So if there's a yes, there's a lot of work to be done. We've already appointed all our advisors and so forth. So we're looking forward to meeting with the investors in this week, telling this beautiful story that's Minergy.
And I suppose you've had a busy year. You've had a lot of supportive shareholders and investors with you along the way.
Correct. We've had a very, we call it the family, and everybody's been helping us, just not from a monetary perspective, but also the support. So, you know, we've been helped by the Botswana shareholders specifically for the country, showing a different investment type, like compared to the diamonds, that's normally their main income earner. So they're excited about that. We've been supported by them, and then, you know, you get your other emotional support from all the other shareholders, excited to see this thing going.
Mm. And I suppose you'd be quite keen to start talking about dividends when you're in a position to?
For sure. And one of the objectives we want to achieve is to reward our shareholders for sticking with us, you know, and that's why we're concentrating on getting this project into cash as soon as possible, and do the stability of supply, profitability and so forth. So the sooner we do that, which is very short term for us, we'll generate all the cash, and we want to pay back very, very, very quickly. We've got an aggressive dividend policy. It could be up to 50% of free cash flows, but all these things are always dependent on board approvals, solvency, liquidity tests and so forth. But, you know, we don't want to sit on cash. We don't have to expand. Most of our capex has been spent, so we want to reward our shareholders.
And so it's all eyes on hitting that steady state production. September, it's going to be a big month for you.
September is a big month for us. Pulling out all the stops, getting everybody to understand that's the objective. So pushing hard for that.
Really good to see you. Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.